When CATL first unveiled its Nextra sodium ion battery alongside FreeVoid dual power and Shenjin superfast charging batteries during its Supertech Day on April 21, 2025, many were not prepared. Imagine a battery that works both in freezing winter and hot deserts, yet it won't even catch fire. A battery that passed the nail penetration, the high drilling test, the sawing test when it's fully charged and the voltage is still stable. CATL confirmed that Nextra has officially entered mass production and is expected to ramp up output, reportedly starting as early as June 2025, with full-scale manufacturing underway by late 2025. This battery showed a critical shift away from lithium dependence, which is scarce, to tapping into sodium availability and abundance. That means cheaper raw materials, more stable prices, and less geopolitical risk. In fact, in their recent YouTube video, CATL claimed Nextra passenger EV cells could reach 175 watt-hour per kilogram at approximately 10,000 plus cycles, negative 40 degrees Celsius to plus 70 degrees Celsius operation and 500 kilometers range. Experts believed with CATL, there would be sodium ion market growth, probably under $1.5 billion by 2030. To put this in perspective, global EV sales in 2024 alone were worth over $500 billion, and they're expected to double by 2030. If sodium ion hits even a fraction of that, say 5 to 10%, we're not talking $1.5 billion anymore, we're talking tens of billions. That's the kind of jump Nextra could trigger if it convinces automakers to switch from lithium to sodium at scale. How safe is CATL Nextra? From what was demonstrated on their YouTube video, it's very safe. Their engineers run this through extreme safety tests. They ran a multi-axis continuous crush test on it, attacking it from multiple directions. A semi-cylindrical crush plate with a 75mm radius was used, and they pressed down on the battery along its x-axis until it deformed by about 30%. They also did on the z-axis, squeezing it to 15% deformation, before moving to the y-axis for another 30%. Yet the fully charged battery remained charged after the multi-axis crushing. It's one thing to design a battery that performs well in ideal lab conditions. It's another to make one that can take this kind of abuse and remain safe with no explosion. To ensure it's even safer and reliable, they also ran it through an 8mm temperature resistance needle, through a high-speed drilling test and a sawing test. Yet no fire. Temperature extremes? Nextra thrives from minus 40 degrees Celsius to plus 70 degrees Celsius. In fact, even at minus 40 and just 10% charge, it can still deliver 90% of its usable power. It also has 5C super-fast charging, adding 520 kilometers in 5 minutes, a game-changer. CATL's test shows that Nextra's sodium-ion chemistry, combined with their engineering design, offers a level of resilience that could redefine safety expectations in electric vehicles, heavy-duty transport, and grid storage. Sodium mining has been less environmentally destructive than lithium or cobalt mining. Sodium is also an easier and cheaper recycling process that could make sodium ion greener over its life cycle. CATL can even tap into sodium sources in seawater and mineral deposits like soda ash, locally and globally. The best part? There would be massive reduction of carbon footprint compared to lithium ion EVs. Should the EV market brace for the impact? Definitely. This will definitely disrupt all balance. Because CATL 10,000 plus cycles showed that if used daily, the pack could theoretically last 25 plus years, which is far beyond the typical 8 to 12 year EV lifespan. The crazy part is that the 5C rate being equal to 520 kilometers in 5 minutes isn't just that it's faster than Tesla superchargers, but about 8 times quicker than current mainstream EVs. At this rate, it could even completely rewrite winter EV ownership, as most lithium-ion EVs lose 20 to 40% range in freezing conditions. And CATL's Nextra reportedly keeps 90% usable power at 40 degrees Celsius. If Nextra becomes successful, it means more EVs on the road, as it will address major concerns on speed charging, costs, and range. Aside from EVs, Nextra would be great for various energy storage. CATL is also developing Nextra batteries for heavy-duty trucks, which would reduce cost compared to lead-acid batteries. And because Nextra's cycle life and safety make it perfect for stationary energy storage, it could quietly dominate the grid market before EVs, like LFP did in China. Who else is in the game? Faradion is pioneering non-aqueous sodium-ion tech, and they are backed by Reliance Industries, focusing on mobility and grid storage. There's opportunity for scalability via existing lines. Tiamat also has fast-charging high-power batteries, 5-minute charge. They received 30 million euros for a 5 gigawatt-hour factory by 2029. Their strength is the fact that it can charge in 5 minutes. Natron Energy being the first U.S. company to produce sodium ion commercially, hit UL safety standards scaling to 24 gigawatt hours per year by 2028 with a $1.4 billion gigafactory. Hina Battery also released Hi-Sing sodium ion solution, which is approximately 165 watt hours per kilogram, full charge in 20 to 25 minutes, and has a longevity of approximately 8,000 cycles. Experts even predicted affordable mass market potential for Hina Battery. Even Northvolt also developed sodium ion cells with 160 plus watt hour per kilogram energy density, using abundant materials, aiming at energy storage. But CATL Nextra is still leading with 175 watt hour per kilogram and a 500 kilometers range with approximately 10,000 plus cycles. While CATL's Nextra battery earned plenty of praise for surviving extreme crush, nail penetration, and drilling tests without explosion, some people aren't convinced just yet. The skepticism boils down to one main point. All the tests so far have been run by CATL itself, and some feel it's all marketing, and they won't fully buy the idea until a third party does the test, not CATL. In fact, it should be done by individuals to actually test and see if the claims are true. And also what happens when you overcharge, as that's the cause of EVs catching fire. In many EV fire cases, thermal runaway has been triggered not by physical damage, but by faults in charging systems, leading to excessive voltage or heat. Skeptics believe CATL hasn't shown public footage of deliberate overcharging tests, and they want to know whether Nextra's sodium ion chemistry can truly stay stable under that condition. And more questions like, shouldn't CATL do short-circuiting between cells in a bigger pack, are being asked. They have seen that the single-cell testing was impressive, but EV batteries operate in a bigger interconnected pack. That means short circuits between cells or in the pack's busbars can create cascading heat and failure modes. So CATL has more work to do: demonstrate what happens when a multi-cell pack is shorted. Yes, Nextra is strong for sodium ion, but it's still lower than the best lithium ion or future solid-state cells, which could possibly limit ultra-long-range EVs. Will CATL Nextra be another solid-state battery hype? No, CATL Nextra is less likely to be another solid-state hype. Solid-state batteries promised huge energy density and safety, but didn't push through because it was too expensive, too hard to make, and they don't last in the real world just yet. Unlike CATL's Nextra battery that's already in mass production, using cheap and abundant sodium, it even works in extreme temps, and now it's being slotted right into existing lines. Yes, sodium ion batteries generally weigh more than lithium ion for similar energy density because sodium atoms are heavier and larger. But CATL is countering this by optimizing cell-to-pack integration, reducing structural components, and using advanced lightweight materials in vehicle battery housing. This could be the future of EV. What if LFP and solid-state batteries double down? Yes, the probability of solid-state battery breakthroughs could overtake sodium ion if they scale faster is high. The clause is if. It's also worthy to know that LFP is already cheap and proven, so Nextra needs to clearly beat it in cost or performance to convince automakers to switch. Aside from EVs, Nextra is coming for other sectors. Imagine your drone still flying in intense snow, and your laptop also lasting 20 years without a battery swap. Or better, your e-bike charging in minutes with no possible explosion. So even if CATL doesn't eventually make Nextra batteries for EVs, they could reach markets that need safe, cheap, cold-tolerant batteries. What's the way forward? CATL should answer the questions of the batteries being overcharged. Let third parties perform tests on multi-pack short circuit, and then mass produce it in the grid sector to scale. But the bigger question is, would you trust a CATL Nextra battery in your car?